growing up on a farm, I had an interest in agriculture, but I knew I didn't want to go back to the farm and actually farm and raise cattle. And whenever I came into the College of Ag at Texas Tech, I really thought I would only be there probably a semester or a year, but I was there because I had a scholarship. And I thought, well, I'll find another major because I wanted to go into a very science-based field. And I'd never even heard about food science. And once I went into the animal science department and heard about food science and food technology, I knew that it was something that really interested me. And from my first class in there, I just really enjoyed it, knew right away I wanted to go into a career in the food industry and study food science and food technology. We have several research projects we're working on right now. We really focus on both pre-harvest and post-harvest food safety. Pre-harvest being in the live animal and post-harvest being in the meat product itself. Some of the pre-harvest work we do is looking at interventions that kill E. coli before the cattle actually go to be harvested. And one of the big things we have done is we've developed a direct fed microbial, which is a lactobacillus bacteria that we can feed to cattle. So it's a good bacteria that kills the bad bacteria. We've done a lot of work on that, and we're going to be expanding that work this summer to salmonella and other types of bacteria to see what it kills. Some of the things on the post-harvest side we've looked at are interventions that actually kill the bacteria before the product gets to the consumer. So we've looked at things like acid washes, heat treatments, and even we've developed a microwave treatment that can cold pasteurize not only meats, but also eggs, peanuts, and other products. A lot of our work really has shifted to Mexico, and we do both research and training there. Foodborne illness is the number one cause of death in children under 5 in Mexico, and it's very preventable. And it's our goal to reduce the amount of salmonella and E. coli and other pathogens in the food supply in Mexico by working with the processing plants and the animal growers and the retail markets to reduce the amount of bacteria that gets to the consumer. We feel like just about everything we do is service. What our goal is to really serve the industry and the consumer and just people worldwide by providing the world with a safer food supply. That's really our motto or our vision within this program. But the way we do that is by working with our scientific journals to make sure that the information gets out and it's correct. And so we do serve, not only myself, but other members of our group serve on a number of editorial boards. We also teach a lot of outreach classes to the industry, HACCP training to everyone from the fruit and vegetable to the meat to the pet food industry. So that's a huge part of our service component. Teaching in Mexico, again, is part of our service. So we really have a lot of interaction with our stakeholders so that not only we don't just sit in the lab and do the work, that what we do actually makes an impact and improve public health in the long term. So just really focus on what you love and following that in order to be successful in all three areas, because it's very difficult if you come in and say, I have to do 30% of each area, or I must do a very regimented structure, but really focus on what you love and the other parts just kind of come naturally.